questions, we are going to see about the structure of the test groups. The structure of the test groups includes the group of specialists. Group of specialists who have the responsibilities and motivations to maintain testing policy statements, after that plans the testing efforts and monitor and tracking testing efforts, then measure the process and product attributes, after that provide the product and process quality information, then design and execute the test with no duplications, then automate testing, then participate in reviews to quality issues, then training testing tool usages and participating in inspection and walkthrough staffing issues, for example hiring and firing, the evaluations of the test team member. Next one, the test lead. The test lead assists the test managers. The test lead responsible for duties such as test planning, staff supervisions and status reporting. The test leads participates the test design, test executions, reporting and technical reviews and customer interactions and tool trainings. Then duties of the team members. It has four part team, test manager and test leaders and test engineers, then junior test engineers. First one, test manager. Test manager concentrate the quality issues, then testings. Testing manager is usually responsible for test policy making, customer interaction, test planning, test documentations and controlling and monitoring the test. Then we are going to see the test engineers. The test engineer to design, develop, execute test and develop test corners, set up test laboratory and environments. They also give the input to test planning and support the maintenance of the test. After that, we have to maintain the defect repository also. Next one, the junior test engineers. The junior test engineers gain experience by participating in test design, test execution and test harness development. And then maintain the user manuals and maintain the test and maintain the defect. Then technical training program. The technical training program is very important for organizations. The technical training program cover the topics such as quality issues, measurements, identifications, then collections and analysis, testing techniques and methodologies, design techniques, tool usages, configuration management, planning, process evaluation and improvements, policy development, DMM levels. Next, it is important that members of the training teams have. Training teams important. First one, experience and education in software engineering. After that, good oral and written communication skill and strong technical skills and tool usages and evaluations and willing to serve as mentor, then ability to support technology transfer. Next, in the training plans, the following items should be included. Staffing requirements for the training teams and identifications of areas that have specific training needs, then goals for the training courses, then a time frame for the training courses should be set, then funding sources for the training programs need to be identified. After that, materials, facilities and tools needed should be identified. Then staff members who will receive the training should be identified. Then training educations should be effectiveness of the training programs can be measured. Then organization can design to support internal training groups and external training groups. Thank you.